with others. Yes.
You know, that's a very, very touchy subject today, especially in the church world. We are in this era in the church where just everybody's a hater. I can't stand this person.
Oh,
this
God.
This one's trying to undermine me. This one's trying to undercut me. This one's after my husband. This one's after my wife. I want to be in the forefront. I want to be under the table. Yes, right. And if we don't, you know, in all seriousness, if we don't fix this problem,
that's right.
We don't get this resolved, we're going to lose the world.
Amen.
Yes. I don't know. I'm in these streets a lot. I didn't grow up in church like many of you all. I've been in the church for like 20 years, and she's like the veteran among us in the church. But the word out there is we dysfunctional. That's the word out there. The word on Gates Avenue, the word on Harlem, the word there. And you know what they say? They say, y'all church folks are dysfunctional. But then they turn around and say, but y'all want us to be like you? Y'all telling us about this God named Jesus, and you're telling us to do all these things.
Talk about your barbershop experience.
Oh, my barbershop experience was I was in a barbershop one day. And you know, that's what church was meant for.
Yeah.
That's our church. You guys have that church before. And the beauty salon, that's where all the men, because men talk too, no fool yourself. We talk behind each other's back. We talk about y'all sometimes. Talking, the man was saying that, you know, sometimes you hear things, and the man would say, you know, I heard about church, I talk about church a lot, but you know what? The church ain't gonna make it. That's what they said. Mm-hmm. The man said, and the man is a ranked sinner now. The man said that the church is going, and I didn't say I'm a Christian, I kept listening. I wanted to hear what he was saying. He said that the church is not gonna make it because they do what we do. Mm-hmm. They fighting among each other.
Oh my!
The bishop is fighting, and this is why you got to be careful because they watch it.
Yes, they do.
They know the speaking in tongues. They know the dancing. They said we saw the bishop in the pastor fighting the other day. We saw the two churches fighting about members. We saw them fighting about money. We saw the church, the mother and the superintendent fighting each other. We saw this. They call each other haters on Facebook. They call each other lying. You think they my sister so and so said my brother so and so did that?
Oh my goodness.
They watching us.
They watching.
And right now our response so far is like they don't want nothing to do with us. Let's just be real. They don't want nothing to do with church. You know why? Because they're saying is how you telling us to be like you and look what you doing worse than we are. Y'all look worse than we are. Well, they are saying basically, how can you tell us to love God and look how y'all love him? Look how we love him.
That's right.
It's a scary thing. And I'm not saying this to rebuke or hurt anybody, but it's something for the church world to really wake up. Because we're supposed to be for standing for God. We're supposed to be demonstrating the faith.
Right.
But to them, they're looking on the outside. Because sometimes the one on the outside looking in is the one that really is understanding what's going on.
Right.
And see, the world is even saying, what's going on with the church? Because see, even the unrighteous understand that if the church is out of order, if the church is dysfunctional, if the church is fighting among each other, we all gonna be lost.
Yeah.
And so saints of God, as y'all talking about this, this is why we in the church, the body of Christ, really gotta get on our pulse.
Yes.
Some work in the schools, some working in daycare, some work in the public sector, some work in the private sector. If we don't get on post and get back on strategy, we gonna lose this generation. I'm for real. You look at the Muslims that's out there. See, while we're dancing in the churches, they witnessing. While the atheists and the agnostics, while we sitting up here fighting about who's on first, they already got strategy operating. They're on Facebook, they're on social media. They are telling you, they are dictating culture and policy and trends for your children and my kids. That's why the people across the street, look at all the projects across the street on Gates Avenue. The Bloods are over there. They rule that over there.
Yeah.
They're not going to come in here because you know what they're thinking is? They're thinking is, why would I go there? They living just worse than me.
Wow.
Yeah, you can say something.
So I agree with everything that Pastor Daniels is saying, because when he comes in from his little barbershop escapades, he tells me about what they're saying, the people outside the church. And it's so alarming and so sad, because our God, as someone said before, is a relational God. And that's why he came down through 40 and two generations, and like you said, suffered what he suffered so that we could be in relationship with him. And the thing about it is that all throughout the Bible, the Lord talks about being a relationship. It tells you how the older women are supposed to instruct the younger women, how we're supposed to raise our kids, how we're supposed to treat our spouses. Hallelujah. And that's the thing that I wanted to focus on, because it's the destruction of the family. Now, when Pastor Daniels and I will be married this year, 22 years.
All right.
What babies when we got mad? Don't do the math, but we were about 23. But anyway, when we came together, Pastor Daniels was not in the church, but I was born and raised in the church. And, you know, they told us growing up, don't go out with anybody unequally yoked or whatever, what have you.
Right.
And I took that very seriously. And Pastor Daniels, at the time, he was a Muslim, and he believed that we could live, I do my thing, and he do his. I was like, no. But I thank God that through prayer, the Lord saved him. Hallelujah. And he's been saved 23, 24 years. And I thank God that he stayed with the Lord. And someone, you know, I remember when he had to go tell his father, which was the hardest thing for him to do. And his father said, oh, I'm not listening to you. You're going through a phase. Once a Muslim, always a Muslim. He said, no, Dad. I live for Jesus Christ. And I thought that's what really did it for me. I was like, wow. Thank you, Lord. And this is why to this day, he is still here, because he had an encounter with the Lord. And I thank God, because when you're talking about marriage, and that's what I want to focus on today, because when we got married, I was like, you believe in divorce? He said, no, I don't believe in divorce. I said, okay, so let's not make each other miserable. I said that. Yeah. We're going to work on it. We ain't going to make each other miserable. But how many of you know that that's easier said than done?
Yes.
It's easier said than done. And it took a lot for us to get where we are. We are what we are because of the grace of God. Let me tell you something about the Lord talking. Let me tell you what the Lord did to me. Because, you know, I was kind of fast with the mouth, you know. You just ain't going to say it to me. You know. So you're not my mother, but act like it. Take the garbage out when I tell you, I'm, you know, just running off at the mouth. But yet, you know, growing up in church, I said, yeah, I know you the head, and, you know, I'm going to submit myself. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you something. It takes the Holy Ghost, and it takes God to work with. I was sitting at my job. I was saying, you know what? I kept going from job to job to job. I just don't know why I could. And I was like, these people just don't like me. These supervisors don't like me because I'm saved. Mm. And sitting right there at my desk, God said, you have a problem with authority.
Oh.
Okay? You have a problem with authority. Now, when God tells you something, you can't, your arm's too short to box with God. I can't get mad. He said, it would be on. It would be on. Hallelujah. It would be on.
Jesus.
And we had what we call the 3-year war. First 3 years of marriage, it was a war going on.
Water don't roses.
Let anybody tell me, I'm grown.
Hey, he wasn't even.
I wasn't gonna let you out talk me. I went to God.
Yes.
And that's what I did, because see, my thing was, if you're in this faith called Christianity, God should be able to answer you if you have a problem.
Oh, yeah.
I went to God. Mm-hmm. And I told the Lord, I said, Lord, you're going to have to help me. This woman won't, you know, talk anymore. I don't want her. I tell her, go left, she go right. I tell her, go left, she go down. I tell her,
go left. Help.
I got on my knees and I said, Lord, you got to tell me what to do. And the Lord told me very, very precise. He said, stop fighting with Dianne.
All right.
Just like that, stop fighting with Dianne. And I said, huh?
That ain't the answer you want.
So one day I said, well, let me try this because let me try this what happens. So one day she, you know, something was going on in the house.
The garbage.
Yeah, the garbage.
She remembers.
And she was about to, you know, ready to come out, left field, ready to come. And all of a sudden I was about to go in, and all of a sudden I said, wait a minute, I'll say something. I said, she was like, didn't I tell you to come out there? I said, okay. So it was like a, and she was like, I said, I'll get the garbage done for you in a few minutes, all right? She was like, quiet for a second. And I said to myself, and I remember the Lord said, Lord, since I'm fighting, so our community, I'm talking to Lord, so one day she said, yeah. And I said, well, I'm going to do something, because I used to get mad. Mm-hmm. I said, ain't no woman be telling me that. I told her it's expected. This time, I said, I was talking very calmly. I said, I'm going to do X, Y, and Z tomorrow. And then tomorrow we will talk about it. She was so quiet. I said, this Bible really is real. This God is really real. So I started doing some other things. I said, well, since that worked, and then that worked, I wonder what would happen if I would sit with my wife and talk to her. So next time I said, Dianne, I want to talk to you this week. Let's all get together and let's sit down. And my wife was sitting there in horror. Where's the real Anthony at? What you doing here? See my husband. I said, let's sit down and talk. And I said, we gotta stop fighting. We gotta stop us arguing because it's not getting nowhere. Because God showed me that if you keep fighting with your wife, you're not your prayers. Supplication. Yes. Uh-huh. It's gonna be hindered. Yes. I think it hit me when I read that.
Yes, sir.
God led me to that scripture. And I said, okay. So we want to be progressing.
Yes. Right.
We don't want to be degressing. So when I sat dying down, I said, we're gonna take some responsibilities. We're gonna take the helm. And you know, it's like driving because my wife drives. I don't drive. And sometimes, you know, ladies, sometimes when you're used to doing something for so long. And you just, it's kind of hard to stop being the boss of it and let somebody else do it. And sometimes that was the thing when we had to have a serious discussion. So the next thing I did, I started implementing dating. That's really crazy.
Uh-oh.
Because see, once you start, because you know, when you're having success, so I said, let's do this now. So I said, let's have date night now. Now she really looked at me like, you know, tears, crying, the way we going with this now. What are you trying to do to me? You know, we got to share this. I said, we're going to have date night. We're going to go out, we're going to have dinner, and we're going to supplicate, and we're going to enjoy ourselves. And we did it.
Yeah.
And it happened well. And then every time I just kept ever met, because God had shown me one time, he had shown me, well, Andy, you're the head. I need you to be the guy to set the tone and set the order and set the structure and put the policies in place and then Dianne's job implement. Now don't get me wrong now. When you look at the Bible and talk about the word submission, now don't get me wrong. Ladies, you do have to submit. But men, you also gotta turn around and give us something to submit to. Because the whole point is it's just like your job. See, on your job, you have to make every corporation, whether it's the public sector, the private sector, have what you call a mission statement. What is the mission of this corporation to do X, Y, and Z? If you're in the private sector, it is to make money. If you're in the public sector, it's to serve the public. But the goal is that whatever agenda, whoever comes in that corporation to work or to serve, the agenda is put your feelings, which you don't like, to the side, come under that mission and carry it out. So what does that mean for the women of God? Women of God, God don't want you to be a slave. He's not trying to beat you into submission. He's not trying to abuse you or rape you or do anything to you. The idea is because that man is the head.
Yes.
God authorized him to be head. You need a covering. You should. That's spiritual. That's something that's God ordained. I didn't make it up. I told my wife, me and my wife was talking with her. I said, honey, I didn't put the word submission in there. So you got to go to the one and put it in there and deal with him. But in the meantime, you do got to do it.
Yeah.
Because here's the thing. Submission is just not one way. No. Submission is both ways.
That's right.
Because just like he told that woman to submit to that man also got to submit to God. And see, the idea is it's a shared submission. It's shared responsibility. She has certain roles. In her role, there's certain duties, functions, and actions she has to take. In my role, there are certain duties, functions, and actions that I have to take. And so when we recognize that, we find out that your home will run very smoothly.
Right.
My home right now, I love going home. I love going home more than anything.
All right.
The first 3 years, I can't really say that.
Everything.
Right.